Hello everyone, this is a recitation for assignment 5. In this recitation, at first we're going to go through a description of the assignment, and then if you have any question, I'll answer your questions. We know that the passwords are not saved in as a plain text in a file. So because if someone can access the plain text, it means that they can access the password. That's why most of the websites or systems save hash of the passwords. But we want to know, depending on the password, how easy it's to crack the password. I mean, by having some information of the password, can we easily crack the crack the hash that we have and retire the password? So in this assignment, there is 5 part that in each part, a different hash is given to you. You can use different software to solve this parts, such as John the Repair or Hashcat, or if you know any other software, you can use that. But in the first step, you should use this link here that's provided for you and submit something to this link to get the hashes for all parts. In part 1, the string or the password was hashed using MD5. 2 examples are given to you here, like Adam and ASU with their hashes. For part 1, we know that the password has 6 characters. In next part, we know that the password was being hashed using SHA-256. Again, 2 examples is provided. And the hint for this part is that a password is 7 characters. We also know that it's included only lowercase letters, uppercase letters, and digits. These hints are important that you consider while trying to crack the password. In part 3, another hash is used. It's called bcrypt. Again, examples are provided. In this part, we don't know anything about the length of the password, but we know that the password that's been hashed is one of the commonly used passwords. It will help us to crack it, even though we don't know the number of the characters. Part 4 is a custom hash function. It means like it's not just like one MD5 or SHA. Hash function was not used, so to make this custom hash, at first the string was hashed with 100 times with MD5, followed by 100 times SHA-256, and finally 100 times SHA-512. Examples are given to you here, so if you write a code to do so, you can check whether you did it right or not by the examples that provided to you. In this part, the hint that's given to you is that the password has 5 characters and only lowercase characters. For the part 5, it's exactly the same as the previous part, but the only difference is that you don't have any hint or anything, any back knowledge about the password. And as you can see, it has extra credit. As for the submission, you should submit a README file containing your name and ASU ID and the password that you have found for each hash in a format that's given to you here in this box. If you cannot find any of the part, just fill it blank. You don't need to write anything. But you should also provide an explanation of how you do the cracking for each part in the README file. That's it, and now your questions. If you have any questions, you can type your question here so that I can answer your question. The question is, how could we get started? My suggestion would be getting familiar with this software, with one of them. Some student might rather to work with more than one of them, but I think one of them would be enough to solve the problem, learn how to use this software, and then knowing that, you should be able to solve the problem. And the first step is to install this and then use it. Did I answer your question? My recommendation actually is to use Hashcat, but it's something personal. And if you rather, you can write your own program in Python and solve the problem. But any other questions about the description of the program, the assignment, if you have, or okay, I'm gonna stay here for a while if anyone show up and have a question. Again, I should emphasize to start for this assignment as soon as you can, because some of them might be time consuming to execute. For example, for part four, that's a custom hash. After you're done with the programming, it may take a while depending on your machine. The most important thing about your assignment is to start as soon as you can so that you can have the results by the deadline. The question here is part four being hashed layer by layer. Yes, it's hashed layer by layer. At first we do 100 time MD5, followed by 100 time the other one, and so on. Yeah.